around. Things are getting crazy. First, it's like cool, this astronomical, you know, astral projection space type of vibe. And then now we're just in the fire, you know? I don't know. I'm scared. What's up, guys? Thank you so much for coming back to my YouTube channel. For those of you who are new here, my name is Michaela, and I'm so happy that you came to chill with me so that we can vibe and watch some music videos and just talk about cool ideas and concepts. So, today's very exciting. We're gonna be breaking down and talking about the Travis Scott and Fortnite collab where they did a live concert, and it's called Astronomical. I haven't seen it, but just hearing about it, just knowing that somebody did this and it's called Astronomical, I'm very excited. It looks very synthwave, very cool. I just think the whole concept of a live concert via video game is just gnarly and it's very exciting. I actually wish I knew about it and participated in it because I would love to see that live. You just can't really, I don't know, there's something about live. What's gonna happen next? You don't know, it's not written, yet there's also a comfort in not in knowing what's gonna happen. You know, there's some people that can't rewatch the same movie, and then there's some people that really get a lot of comfort in rewatching the same show and movie. And there's actually, you know, a method to that madness. You know, when you know the ending to something, it's very comforting. Yet we humans crave this level of excitement of actually not knowing what's gonna happen. That's what kind of makes life very interesting. Like, imagine you knew what I was gonna say each time I was talking. I mean, it'd be really boring. It'd be really boring. So hopefully, you know, I could excite you a little bit and then, you know, bring new ideas to front, or maybe we'll have some stuff in common. Anyways, so right off the bat, when you first start, I love the coloring. I usually always start with the coloring. It's just that I can't emphasize how much it just sets a mood, you know? That's why I always have this purple light going on. Just reminds me what vibe I wanna be in. And yeah, let's just hop right into it. Literally hop right into it. It's called Astronomical. Let's put on our astral projection vibes and get into this.
Sun is down, freezing cold. That's how we already know when it's here. My dog will probably do it for Louis Bell.
Okay, so right off the bat, I just love how these little oh my god, I don't even know what to call them. The characters, the game characters are just straight on a headbanging, and like I totally feel them because that's exactly what I would do if I was there. I'd just be like straight on headbanging, but they're like really serious.
That's just all he know, he don't know nothing else. I tried to show him. Yep. 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 Gone on you with the pick and roll. Young and flame, he and sickle.
That at 1:20, this cosmic event pretty much just happens, you know, Travis Scott just pops up all big and animated, and I guess my character just flies back, because that's what it feels like. I feel like I'm there. I don't know, I'm just having a great time right now. This is super cool. I love it. This is not the first time that we see Travis Scott, you know, doing this kind of animated style stuff. He did this music video called 90210. It's one of my favorite music videos. I think it's super creative, very artistic, with Hype Williams, and I'll actually do a music video breakdown on that because it's just really fun, and I really do love the song. I was actually gonna do that before doing this, but anyway, so you know, he's just so, so creative. And that just blew me away, literally. Like, I actually feel like I was that character. I'm having so much fun watching it. And it's just very interesting that he called it Astral World. Not this event, but this one is called Astronomical. But, you know, he had Astral World, the album, and he made that whole amusement park. And that's actually in his documentary, Look, Mom, I Can Fly, he did, he actually grew up by going to this amusement park called Astro World, and he like brought it back to life. And I just think that's really cool, going back to your childhood. So for those of you who may or may not know, there's something called astral projection. Now, I used to try it, or tried to try it, when I was like 14, 15. It's pretty scary. I don't want to do it, but you can Google it. There's a lot of people who have experienced this. I don't know if you have, or if you know what it is, or you're just kind of like, oh, that can never happen. But there's people who claim that they have astral projected before. And what is astral projection, you may ask? It's kind of like this. It's pretty much an out-of-body experience where you go on adventures, I guess, with your mind, with your consciousness, with your soul, whatever it is that you believe in, but that's not your body. So basically, whatever it is that's up here travels and goes on an adventure. And that's what I think is so cool about this, is I feel like we're actually, you know, we're going to Astral World. We're astral projecting to Astral World. And that's pretty much what was going on, I guess, because we were all in this world in a way. I guess we all participated in astral projection, since our minds, our consciousness, was in that video game. For whoever participated, we were there. And pretty much, in a way, freaky enough, you're kind of here, or I'm where you are, right? Because although I'm physically not there, my voice is making sound wherever you are. So technically, doesn't that count for something? I mean, there's a lot of experiments science-wise where people measure sound, and sound has frequency and energy. So in a way, does that mean that that person's energy is there? And if that person's energy is there, then doesn't that mean a part of them is there? Same thing with, let's say, an artist. You know, they paint a painting, and you have that painting in your room, let's say. You kind of have a piece of that artist with you. Or let's say I'm listening to a song, right now I'm listening to Travis Scott. In a way, a part of his consciousness or mind is actually here with me. So it's pretty interesting to think about when you think about artists and or creators, or even just FaceTiming, you know, FaceTiming your friend or your mom, and you know, they're not physically there, but a part of them in a way is there. It's like if something happened, they would be witness to it. So aren't they there? I don't know. It's pretty interesting. And I just love that we are all pretty much astral projecting into this concert, and who knows what will happen in the future. All right, let's get back into it. James, think my jewelry really selling fruits, and they joking, man, know the is what you wasn't know. Okay, so this would be super sick in VR 360. I know some artists have done the whole VR 360 experience where their music video is literally, if you have that virtual reality, those goggles, they do, you know, a specific music video where they film it, and you're basically like in it. And the first one that I've ever seen was Saturn Burns by Gorillaz, and this actually propelled me to do that VR virtual reality therapy session series that I did. If you guys are interested in seeing that, it's really dope. I will put that in there in the link in bio. It's pretty interesting if you're interested in this whole, you know, astral projection, virtual reality, subconscious type of talk and feel. It's very creative and artistic, so maybe you'll enjoy it. And one of the, I think, funnest series that I've filmed. But anyway, so this is just reminding me of what it would be like. Like, would you guys attend a virtual reality concert? Would you guys pay tickets to see that? Is that the future? Is that what we'll have to do? Because apparently, you know, there's no more concerts happening for a little while. So would that be something that you would participate in? And if you don't have the VR goggles, would you just participate in a live concert? I know a lot of creators are doing a lot of Instagram lives, and that's been, you know, keeping people afloat, you know, just keeping them vibing. But this is a whole nother experience. Like, what if they really upped the experience that if you bought a ticket, everybody received, you know, I don't know, these VR goggles, and there was a time and a date, and you had your own avatar. That's what it's called, avatar. You have your own little avatar, and I guess we astral project into astral world. And this astronomical event, I don't know, this is pretty cool. I would actually participate in it. Depending on how much it would be, I'd definitely be somebody to participate in that. I don't know, it just sounds so cool. And if we can't go to concerts, I mean, that's awesome. Imagine they like did, you know, album releases like this. I don't know, I'm just thinking outside of the box here. Okay, like 3 minutes and actually 33 seconds. Things are getting very interesting. I mean, it's all red, you know, fire's coming out, all the avatars are running around. Things are getting crazy. First it's like cool, this astronomical, you know, astral projection space type of vibe. And then now we're just in the fire, you know? I don't know, I'm scared. It was a silver fade before no Cardinals, baby, because she played the tourist guide. That cat avatar though is still going at it. She's still vibing. She's like raving till the end. You know, some ravers are just like, I don't know, they're just going at it. They can't stop, won't stop. So I aspire to be like her. And you have one avatar just like holding this bar that's like on fire. And I just feel like, I don't know, they're such ragers. Like, where can I find these characters? And can I invite them to chill? Please, I'm lonely. All right. Okay. So Javis God is just this big avatar and he's just like, just shooting out electricity, and I don't know, it's a great time. And then he just created a bunch of little Travis Scotts, and their energies are just, you know, being electric. And I feel like that's what energy looks like. I don't know if we're getting a little bit too deep here, but I just feel like that's just so cool. I feel like when a creator or an artist is performing, that's what they feel like, you know? You ever see them finish like a concert and they're just like, kind of just gave myself a panic attack there. If you ever want to feel like what a panic attack feels like, guys, I'm lightheaded. Woo! Woo! Yeah. If you ever want to feel like what a panic attack feels like, don't do it. I don't know why you'd want to feel like that. You can just take a deep breaths in and out, really fast. I mean, breathe, but I love this move. What is this? Travis Scott just going like. Oh, I love it. Trying to say that all my problems ain't probable. I don't know what that means, but I'm down. Or maybe I got the lyric wrong, but I feel you, you know? They're trying to say that my problems aren't problems, you know? Hate when that happens. Hate when they're not probable. Damn. I probably got it wrong, but I'm having a good time. So try and stop me. Oh no, oh no. The anxiety is kicking in. I love when the music winds down. You know what I'm saying? When it's just a little whining down there. Something's gonna happen. I get those goosebumps every time. Back in the behind. Go down to the side. Yeah. I get those goosebumps every time. Yeah. When you know, I love this girl like with a butterfly backpack just chilling. This is a straight a vibe, okay? If I could astral project in the astronomical live event again, I will. And apparently there will be more concerts to attend to. That's what I saw on this website. So maybe I will be doing, maybe I could be doing it live and recorded. That'd be super fun. But anyways, for now, we're straight vibing. This girl has this backpack on. She's chilling. We're chilling. We're having a good time. She's Besides, this is so much cooler. I mean, right now we're underwater, okay? You can't do that at a live concert, right? And this is cheaper too, you know? At a live concert, you play like what? Like, I don't know, $400? I mean, these concerts are pretty expensive. I wish it could be $25 back in the day when, I mean, I don't even go to these big type of concerts, to be honest with you. When I did go to shows, it would actually be mostly dubstep shows and they'd be like $25. So like, I don't know. But these concert tickets are pretty expensive. And you know what? Do you go underwater? You don't, okay? So better recheck. No, I'm just joking. Support your artists. It's pretty cool. Do what you want. But this is awesome. I mean, we're underwater right now. So it also depends how creative you can get. Towards the end of the concert, we see the vibe switch up a little bit in the new song that Travis Scott just released called The Scots. I love this whole new, I don't even know really what to call it. It's like the synthwave retro type of vibe. I mean, now I think it's getting really popular. The Weeknd just released an album and two of his songs kind of had that retro synthwave type of vibe. I'm super into it. I've been on this wave for a little bit of a while. I've been on the synthwave for a little bit. But I actually noticed it becoming in after Stranger Things. Stranger Things, you know, had that really cool theme song because obviously it was in the 80s, you know, the retro vibe stems from the 80s. And now I feel like we're putting our own futuristic spin on this retro vibe. I don't know. Tell me what you guys want to call this vibe or what you guys think it should be called. I don't know really what to call it, but right now I'm very into the synthwave, cyberpunk, retro, futuristic vibes that are going on here, and that's totally what I'm getting from the ending of this. You have that tune that tune with the very, you know, futuristic cyberpunky stuff, because we're astral projection going on an astral ride here. And yeah, that pretty much concludes the live concert. That was really cool, guys. I enjoyed that with you too. Thank you so much for joining me on this concert. Thanks for walking me home. That's what it'd be like to date me. Just joking. We'd have way more fun. You know, every girl's cool until she's your girlfriend. Just saying. Anyways, so let's not get into this, okay? Okay. So yeah, overall, this was awesome. I love that it's pretty interesting how it's called, you know, Astronomical. Astral World came out like last year. Now all we can really do to go places is pretty much astral project. So you know what? I better get on it because I'm losing it here. So if I could learn astral projection, that'd be pretty cool. I mean, who's to say we don't really do it when we dream, right? I don't know. So many questions, so many things, so little time. Just joking. We can keep going. Just tell me what you guys are into talking about. But we'll keep it at that right now. You know, absorbed a lot of information, a lot of headbanging going on. So we'll leave it at that. But thank you guys so much for coming back to my channel. For those of you who are new here, I hope to see you next time because it's really cool chilling and having a great time. I enjoy doing this a lot. And yeah, you guys rock. See ya in my dreams, maybe. I don't know. Bye.